Like that little emoji that's just like. Hi YouTube, I'm Janae Mercer and I'm here to help you feel a little bit more normal. Today we're gonna talk about some of the reasons that you shouldn't compare yourself to influencers in their photos, the stuff they do, and why it's not just the gal next door. Before I jump into that, please, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Remember to subscribe and go ahead and smash that notifications button. It all helps me get cat food for two of my cats because I've got a second one now. And I've had coffee, as you can tell. All right, so today we are gonna talk about angles and we're gonna talk about camera lenses and camera types and iPhone camera types. And the big difference these make in photos when it comes to how influencers capture their bodies. There's a whole bunch of other stuff we can talk about, like how they style their bodies with things like boob tape or body makeup, so that kind of aesthetic thing, or gym kit with like booty scrunching or lighting or 1,001 other things that I will do as part of this, like pulling back the curtain series is what I've just decided. I'm gonna call it. Let's start with angles. When I first started working in magazines, going on sets of photo shoots was one of the most eye-opening things to me because you see, like, there's usually one girl in the shot, but then around her, there's an entire team, whether it's hair and makeup, stylist, the camera person's assistant, the editor, the creative director, and you know, this whole team to create this one very simple image. And some of the stuff you see, it's skill on both parts, right? It's like the photographer has skill because he knows or she knows what kind of lens to use, how to angle and position the camera. And then the model has skill because she knows how to work her body, what to do, how to pose, how to use her angles. But the thing is I think now we know that that happens with magazines. Like, we might not understand the ins and outs of it, but we know that behind that one person, there's like 20 people. This also happens with influencers. It happens, it happens in so many ways, whether the influencer themselves knows their angles, they know how to work their body, they know lighting, they know poses, or if they hire a professional photographer, which quite a lot of them do, or if they have a partner who's a professional photographer, also very common. You know, it happens in so many different ways. So that is my goal with this series, is just to kind of help remind you and share, I guess, some of the insight that I know from working in media for over 10 years now. About what goes on, not just in magazines, but also with influencers. Let's start with posing. Okay, posing is big, especially for your fitness influencers, your beauty, your fashion, your travel. The way they'll pose will be slightly different, the way fashion poses versus your fitness influencers will pose, but however they're posing to get a desired effect on their bodies. For instance, with fitness influencers, you have, you know, this bum pose. And it is a certain stance that makes your butt look bigger than it is. That is a trend at the moment, big juicy peaches. And a lot of women, fitness influencers, know how to stand to get that juicy peach and how to take that photo. And then they know things like, you know, when you're twisting that much, because essentially you are twisting, you either have a crop top that you pull down over your back rolls or bottoms you pull up over them, or you put your hand right there to hide your back roll. Bikini influencers know how to position their body to create an hourglass figure. Often you'll see them sat on their knees, their bum tipped back, their legs towards the camera, their bum back, their back arched, their core really tight, and it creates this kind of hourglass shape. But if you were to look at them side on, this is kind of what their body would look like. With their legs here, this would be their butt, this would be their head. And the camera is somewhere over here. It'd probably be about right here. So they're making their waist look smaller because it's the farthest thing away from the camera. The nature of my body is I'm pretty like up and down. I don't have, young girl does not have a lot of curves, but I can fake it. I can fake it through how I position my body. So swimsuit influencers know that. Fashion influencers know how to really elongate their lines with how they pose. So it could be standing on their tiptoe. You'll see that a lot, standing on tiptoe, maybe with their shoulders back, even like an arm overhead kind of creates a longer line, which is the opposite of what like fitness influencers are going for because they want like the core popping, the abs popping, the shoulders to look tight, but fashion want a little more, you know. As you can see, I'm not a fashion influencer. Now, there are a whole bunch of influencers that lately have been kind of peeling back the curtain themselves and showing what their body looks like as it moves or in different angles or in different lighting. And I think that's pretty incredible. My goal is that we reach a point where we don't even need this education process, where it's just like normal bodies doing normal stuff, but we have such a far way to go. Like when you look at the main influencer accounts, the huge ones, like the ones with 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 million, they are women who are just doing these poses all the time. And I got a message the other day from someone in the community being like, why do you follow this influencer? She is against everything you stand for. Yes, but I follow her to see what she's doing with her body because she has poses that I've never even thought of, and so I can recreate them and talk to you ladies about, you know, again, she's just a regular lady, but just knows how to work her angles. There are also a few community accounts that are showing what celebrities look like in different angles. Again, highlighting the fact that if you pose, if you know how to work your body, you can look one way, and then if you're just existing normally, it just looks slightly different. I think for me, I'm absolutely fine with people posing, I'm fine with them not posing. At the end of the day, I just want to help you guys understand a bit more of what's happening and what's going on. On that note, let's talk cameras. So, I shared a bit of this on my stories on Instagram the other day, and I was just inundated with questions. And sometimes I think, like, when you're in an industry, you're in a bubble, and you presume that everyone knows everything you know. Like, things like angles, lighting, boob tape, which is gonna be its own episode, so we're not gonna go into that too much. You just think everyone knows about it because it's so common. And camera lenses is one of those things. So depending on the type of camera lens you have, and this could be a professional camera or like an iPhone, Android, whatever camera, depending on the make, the model, if it's front facing, if it's back facing, what setting you've got it on, it creates essentially a different looking body or face. So the easiest way you can test this is just to take your iPhone or your Android, go into Instagram and go into their normal like selfie setting. Bring the camera close to your face and like, I would do it as a video. So bring the camera close to your face, pull the camera away, and then zoom in close to your face. Save that and take a screenshot of both of those. And in an instant, you can see how the camera will distort your face depending on if it's close or if it's far away. If it's closer, it's gonna make bigger eyes, bigger nose, kind of bigger forehead. If it's farther away, it will sort of flatten things a little bit and honestly show your features a little more how they are, whereas that close up is gonna create a bit of distortion. This is something professional photographers have known for years. For years. I had so many photographers write me and say, yeah, of course, that's why I only use this lens or that lens. That's why I only shoot portraits in this mode or that mode. Because they know that the lens changes how your face presents on film. But then this also changes how your body presents on camera. And again, you can use iPhone. I just say iPhone because that's what I use, but I'm sure it exists for Android. You can use iPhone, you can use camera. If you use a wide angled lens, you're gonna create super long lines. We see this a lot in travel influencer photography in particular. Also fashion, definitely fashion. But for me, I think of travel influencers, I think of like that tan, blonde haired girl who is like looking at a forest, at a jungle, and it's shot from behind and your eye just follows up these really long legs, up to her bum, up to her waist, big hair, and then this beautiful setting in the background. And this is like quite a common travel type of shot. It's that framing, that setting where your eye is pulled into the picture by this body essentially. And this body is elongated through a wide angled lens. So the lens itself it kind of creates this fisheye where it draws out the body, it elongates the body, and then the whole setting is kind of exploding around it. I think it's incredible. Like, I like the artistry of all of this. I like everything that I'm going to be talking about in the Pull Back the Curtain series. I think there's no shame in any of it. I'm not here to say this is good, this is bad. I use these techniques myself, 100% use these techniques myself. And I think there's a real art in the same way that the pictures you see in magazines are art. I just think it's maybe helpful for you ladies to know what happens behind the scenes. And again, it doesn't mean that Sally influencer is bad or doing anything wrong. It just means like, here's stuff you should be aware of. All right, gals, I hope that helps. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Drop your questions below. I do read every single comment. Remember to subscribe, hit that like button, do all the things. Helps me get fancy food for my two very hungry, constantly eating, often meowing kitty cats. Bye, guys.